Hello, what's up? In this Photoshop video, I want to share a way to add a very natural but still rich, vibrant, golden hour look on your images. For most of the editing, I will be using the Camera Raw editor. This also means this can be done in Lightroom if you're using that software. But just keep in mind, I will use Photoshop later to finish this whole editing process. So without much more talking, let's jump into it. Now, the very first thing I want to do is to actually crop the image, since I was a little too far away from the subject. So we can make this shot a little more interesting by just taking off some parts of the bottom and the left side. Let's take a bit off from the top as well, but this starts to look way better. You can immediately see the focus lies now way more on the subject here. So let's start working on the tones. First off, I do want to change the profile to Adobe Standard. This will give me a flat image to work with. Then for the white balance, as I said, I want to apply a golden hour-like color on this shot. So let's just turn up the temperature a bit. Also, I want to keep it natural, so I'm not going too crazy here. But that looks pretty cool. So you might not be able to see much of the golden hour light. That's because the sky right now is a bit bright. I want to fix that for the next step. So let's bring down the highlights. And you can now see all those clouds in the sky. And the histogram looks really, really good at that point. Still, we can change things a little further. We can add contrast by reducing the blacks a bit. Maybe let's boost the whites just a tiny bit because we are close to overexposure right here in the bright part. And let's see, I do think I need to boost the shadows some more. All right, now it's still a bit flat for my taste, so I'm going to just add some contrast. All right, let's check the before version and you can see already after those tone adjustments, it's a huge difference. For the next step, let's add a little bit of texture since I want this shot to be sharp. And at the same time, I'm going to slightly drop the clarity to give everything some kind of a dreamy look. Then the colors do look still a little desaturated, so let's bring up the vibrance. Just like that. Nice. And here we have the basic adjustments. Now, I do have a few local adjustments I want to work on. Let's check them out. First off, I do have a mask for some glow effect coming in from the right side. And that's just because the sun is right outside the frame here on the right side. To add the glow effect, I'm simply pushing the blacks. I am also going to boost the temperature a bit, which will introduce some more warm tones in the sky. And then we could even decrease the dehaze here. Just be careful to not overexpose things because that's easily done with this slider. But this looks pretty cool. All right, now I do want to add another mask for the sky. Here I want to specifically target the blue tones of the sky and make them darker. For this reason, I am going to create a color range mask first, and with the color range mask active, I'm going to select a color which I want to change, so the blue part of the sky right here. And since we do have some different blue tones in the sky, I'm going to pick another tone from, let's say, right here. And I'm doing this by holding down the shift key and just clicking in the image. Now, of course, with this mask, we have selected all the blue color tones in this range of the whole image, which I don't want. Since I only want the sky, I need to subtract the foreground using a linear gradient. So let's just drag one up like this. And here we have a perfect sky selection. So with this mask active, let's bring down the exposure just a bit. And I do want to bring down the saturation and maybe the texture and clarity as well, just to get some soft puffy clouds up there. Perfect. And that's it for the local adjustments. Again, let's compare to the before version of the image. Much, much better. Then let's work on the colors for a moment. I'm starting in the color mixer tab with the hue. First off, I'm going to boost the red hue just a bit. Also, I'm going to drop the blue hue, since right now you might not see this, but there is some kind of purple in there which I don't like. So I'm trying to make the blue tones a little more cyan by dropping the hue, just like that. Perfect, then let's switch over to the saturation part. Here I do want to boost all those warmer golden autumn colors. So let's start with red. Then orange, of course. Yellow. And at the same time, I want to drop the green saturation, which will just make the warmer tones even warmer. And that's it for the saturation, I guess. Now let's check out the luminance. And here I do want to boost the yellow luminance. This will mainly affect the foliage in the foreground and make it a little brighter. So I'm going to increase it quite a bit, just like that. Maybe let's actually bring it down, but instead also increase the orange luminance. That looks better. And then we can also adjust the sky somewhere by bringing down the blue luminance, just like that. But I don't want to make it too dark, so that looks perfect. Then let's head into the color grading panel, and for the highlights, I do want to go with a warm, golden-like color tone, somewhere in this range. That looks pretty good. I'm not touching the saturation anymore. So finally, let's go into the calibration tab. Here I just want to bring down the blue primary hue. And I also want to boost the saturation somewhere here. Perfect. Finally, let's sharpen the image. And here we have the image after the raw adjustments. Looks so much better. But now let's finish it in Photoshop. Alright, so I don't think there's much to do. I'm thinking about adding some more glow on the right side. But at this point it might be a little too much. What I do want to change though is the brightness of the church in the center. Here I'm going to apply a new layer, switch the blending mode to overlay. And then I'm using the TK panel plugin to create luminosity masks. In this case, I want to target the midtones first. Let's see. I think this mask could work pretty good. And now I'm simply applying it as a layer mask on the overlay layer. Grab a white brush. Maybe let's lower the opacity. And now I'm just painting over this church here. Just making it brighter, so the focus lies on the church. Quite a difference. I can dodge a few other parts as well. Alright, awesome. Now I don't like how dark those windows are, so I'm going to add a new layer again, switch the blending mode to overlay. And this time, since I want to target the dark windows, I'm using a dark luminosity mask, of course. So this one should be good. Again, I'm just using a white brush to make them a little brighter. Just like that. And here we have a very well exposed subject. So finally, let's merge all those layers. And now we could take a look at the Nick Collection plugin. So what I want to do here first is to add the Brilliance Warmth filter and just add a little more warmth. Not too much, just a little bit. This should be enough. Maybe a little saturation as well. But this looks good. Then let's see if we can add another filter. I do have the polarization effect in mind. It's quite strong on this shot. Let's apply a very low strength here. I guess that's okay. And let's apply it like this. And here we have the finished image. You can see we have way stronger golden hour light without making it look unnatural, and the whole editing process for this shot was rather easy. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.